My name is Lau Chi Xin, and my metric number is 193365, and this is my partner.
My name is Chong Ka Fei, with metric number 194550. Our brand does mainly to work. For information, biotechnology is defined as the use of technique based on living system of substances from living system to make product or improve other species. And there are a lot of sectors involved in biotechnology. For example, marine biotechnology, food biotechnology, agricultural, industrial, or even medical biotechnology. As a scientist to be in future, before today we are going to focus on agricultural biotechnology, as agricultural sector has always been important for Malaysia's economy. However, before we start our presentation today, we would like to ask fellow future biotechnologists one question. What is agricultural biotechnology? Basically, this is a field of agricultural science that use the cell and molecular biology tools to improve the genetic makeup and agronomic development. Over the past decade, agricultural biotechnology has undergone a huge revolution from traditional until the modern agricultural biotechnology we have nowadays. Why was revolution occur in agricultural biotechnology? It was mainly due to a biotechnological manipulation of organisms in traditional method is done at a whole organism level, and typically it is imprecise and take a longer duration of time for the breeding program. Sometimes the unwanted trait might be inherited together with the desired trait in the new generation. Thus, there comes the modern sphere, known as genetic engineering, in which it enables the scientist to extract and transfer the specific genes from one organism to another. And as with the development of new technology, many organisms with a desired trait can be inherited and produced precisely in a short time. The most common traditional biotechnology include the selective breeding and classical breeding with induced mutation. In selective breeding, new varieties are developed either by selecting plants with desirable traits or by combining qualities from two closely related plants. These creatures may be resistant to a particular pest or diseases, as well as tolerance to a climate conditions. For example, cabbage and broccoli are all originated from the same wild mustard plant through selective breeding, as was shown in the screen. And for classical breeding with induced mutation, it occurs naturally and sometimes results in the development of new beneficial traits. Mutation can happen faster in the process named mutagenesis, and radiation and chemicals can be used to change the plant's DNA. The goal is to cause changes in the base pair of in the plant's DNA so that as the DNA provides the biochemical instruction for the growth and development of plants. And thus, in certain plants may possess new and desirable traits to the modification and their genetic materials. And now Law will explain the next.
Thank you. So I will continue with the modern biotechnology. Well, for the modern agricultural biotechnology, such as the recombinant DNA technology and as well as transgenic technology, they include a range of tools that scientists employ to understand and manipulate the genetic makeup of the genetic materials for the production and the processing of the agricultural products. An example of the products including the genetic modified organism, GMO, as you all know that, and the transgenic plants and animals. For recombinant DNA technology, it is a technology which a plant or animal can receive genetic material from a different organism to to improve its attributes or to improve, perform more functions of it. Well, the most significant example is genetic modified organism, as I mentioned just now. So what is the purpose of this method, the recombinant DNA technology? So the purpose is to develop more resistance against the pest and the disease, so it could be more adapt to the extreme environment, the extreme climatic conditions. And for example, the transgenic BT corn is a corn that is genetically modified to contain the spores of the bacterium named Bacillus thuringiensis BT in the short form, which kills the insect that invade the corn. So the corn would stay fresh quite a long time and it can be sold out in a quite high price. So this is the example of the BT corn, the genetic modified corn and the original corn without any genetic modified. So as you can see the difference, the genetic modified corn is quite fresh, compared to the organic corn is quite small and not fresh. Next, this is the tomato, the organic tomato and the GMO tomato. So I will continue with the transgenic technology. So what is transgenic technology? Transgenic technology is a transgenic organism which contains a foreign gene. A foreign gene is a gene which comes from a different species of the organism, or genes which have been artificially inserted into animals or plants instead of having them naturally. So the first genetically modified crop is an antibiotic resistant tobacco plant, which was produced in 1982. In animal example, transgenic technology can be used to produce new materials which contribute more to the society. For instance, the transgenic goats have been bred to produce a milk with proteins from the spider genes, and as a result, it creates a very strong material similar to the spider milk, which can be commercially produced. So this is the tobacco plant, the tunneling, the wall plant. And as you can see, the spider web plus the goat, which produce commercialized strong material. So the conclusion, in this utilization of modern technology era, many organisms with desired trait can be produced precisely, accurately in a short time. And every cultural biotechnology is a continuous growing sector that blends traditional agricultural and modern agricultural technology. And however, as numerous books, articles, and most of the news publication illustrate, this new field is not lacking of critics. Economic, ethical, legal, and safety concerns haunts each new agricultural biotechnology development and will continue to do so in the future. Lastly, as what Mike Pompeo said, feeding the world will be one of the greatest challenges of the 21st century. It will be impossible without using scientific advancement such as the agricultural biotechnology and other sources of biotechnology. So last, the future is on our hands, and let's see how we can improve